Hey, Stanford fans, welcome into another week's edition of the Student Athlete Spotlight presented by Coca-Cola. I'm John McAfee today, happy to be joined by Stanford football linebacker Nathan East. Nathan, I know it's a busy time for you. You got a home game this weekend, but appreciate you making some time and stopping by.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you having me. Happy to be here.
Well, let's start by just talking a little bit about how much you've got going on in your life, because it's a lot more than just football. You're in PT school right now. You just got married over the summer, and you're still finding time to play football at a high level. I mean, how in the world do you manage to balance all of those things?
Yeah, football is kind of the icing on top. It's the fun part. It's definitely been with a lot of help from other people. My professors in the physical therapy department, coaches just kind of helping me balance my schedule. And then, of course, my family and my wife kind of keeping my head on straight through it all. I kind of knew it was going to be a lot, so I kind of, you know, expected to have some challenges at first, but it's going pretty smooth so far. So.
Well, I want to talk a little bit about the number 5 jersey that you're wearing this year. And for Stanford fans that don't know, I think most people that follow the football program do know, but it's in honor of Charles Williams, former Stanford player that passed away in a car accident. It's a big deal every year for this program, and you're selected to wear it this year. What does that honor mean to you?
Yeah, from the memorial standpoint of it, it's humbling to represent Charles Williams and his family. And then just from the what it kind of represents standpoint, it is an honor to be voted on by my teammates, and having been here for so long, I played with all the other number 5s, you know, so Montrell, Liam, Shahid, to name a few, and just seeing their leadership and knowing that I'm kind of in that role now, it's humbling and it's an honor. So.
Well, I want to talk about what your expectations were coming into the season, because obviously going back to last year, the defense was disappointing, to say the least, and it was a little bit of a tough season for you guys, but obviously a lot of new faces coming in, both on the playing side and on the coaching side, including a new defensive coordinator, Chris Boone. So what were your expectations coming into this season?
I think just to be better, which I think we have so far, and I think it started, you know, in the offseason. We knew we were going to have a lot of new faces. Coach Boone bringing his new staff in. We just wanted to be better, and Coach Hatcher always harps on ultimate team game, but it's hard to do that when, you know, offense is carrying most of the weight. So we wanted to set a standard to where the defense can win some games and the offense can rely on the defense to get off the field and let the offense do their thing. So.
You're coming off a week where you were the National Defensive Player of the Week and also the SoCon Player of the Week, and your team is off to a 4-1 start. It's the best start for Stanford football since 2016. When did you start to maybe get a little bit of a sense that, wow, this team could have a pretty special season?
I would say, you know, even during the winter workouts with Coach Mathers, just kind of stressing the little things, knowing that we can't have a repeat of what we had last year and that it's up to us. So starting then, and then, like I mentioned, Coach Boone coming in and just kind of having a new mindset for the defense. And then, of course, going into week one, I think the team was gelling well coming out of fall camp. Everybody, camaraderie was high. We were confident, and I think that has shown the past 5 weeks. So.
Well, you're coming off a huge road win against Furman. You're back home this weekend against Wofford. Last time you guys were here at home, great environment. It was family weekend. You guys come away with a big win over Western Carolina. For that environment, where did that rank for you in your 6 years here? Because it felt like one of the best crowds that we've had in a long time.
Yeah, it was. I remember coming out for warm-ups, and the stands were packed, but I still saw tons of people walking in. I was like, man, this is gonna be a good one. I always love the opening Thursday night games, you know, just starting football season. Everything's all hype, but Western Carolina was definitely in the top of my list.
I mean, how much does that impact you guys on the field, having that crowd behind you?
I think it's big. You kind of zone in as a player, but, you know, when you make a play or it's third down or the offense is in the red zone and you kind of hear that crowd getting loud, it kind of builds energy on the sideline and transfers on the field. So.
Well, fall break this weekend, but hopefully we'll have a pretty good crowd still for Stanford-Wofford on Saturday afternoon. All right, Nathan, we're going to end with some rapid-fire questions. We're going to do some about you, some about your teammates.
All right, let's do it.
All right, we're going to start with some easy ones. Any siblings?
3 siblings.
Okay.
Older sisters.
I'm the
baby. Yep.
Okay. Any pets?
Yes, Bucky, a chocolate lab.
Okay.
Best friend.
Favorite TV show?
Impractical Jokers.
Favorite sport outside of football?
Baseball.
What's your favorite baseball team, pro baseball team?
I say the Yankees. I like Derek Jeter, so I don't really have a team. I kind of follow players, but we'll say Yankees.
What music gets you hyped pregame?
Little Drake, little Morgan Wallen. I like a nice mix.
What would be the team's theme song?
Team's theme song. I don't know why Adele's coming to mind. I need some high pitch, just yelling, good voice, Adele.
Okay. I can get behind that. Favorite Chris Hatcher quote?
All that's coming to mind is as you practice, you shall play. But there's better ones than that.
Has he always had that one? Has that been a thing?
I've heard it for 6 years now. Okay. So. Okay.
What's next for you after football? Dream job, like when you're done with your playing career?
Physical therapist and maybe open some type of training facility for athletes.
Gonna move on to your teammates. Who has the best nickname?
David Coleman. We call him Super Dave. Soup. Coach Boone gave him that name, and it's kind of stuck. So.
Most likely to be a contestant on The Bachelorette.
Let's give it to Kaz. Kazra. He's a flirt.
Which teammate would you most want to live with?
Seth Zimmer.
Okay, why?
He seems like he's on top of his stuff. He's an older, mature guy, so okay. Kind of stays out of the way.
Biggest cheerleader on the sideline?
Shelton Quarles, Jr. Okay. He's a good hype man.
Who has the most fun in the locker room pregame?
Torrance Pollard.
All right, last one. Who's the most intense guy when you're on the field?
Probably Noah Martin. He's got that middle linebacker mentality through and through.
What about you? Are you pretty fired up most of the time?
I'm pretty flat. Yep. Yeah. Don't get too high, don't get too low. So.
Well, Nathan, I appreciate your time. Looking forward to another home game on Saturday.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Bulldogs taking on the Wofford Terriers here at Seibert Stadium, 12 p.m. kickoff. That'll do it for this edition of the Student Athlete Spotlight presented by Coca-Cola.